Coming
the
up
players are really dug in here. They want to get a huge victory over the owners to make up for the losses they had in the previous collective bargaining agreements. And the owners only want to give them a small victory. And the offers made today by the owners, don't make a mistake here. They are a victory for the players, but not big enough.
So that's where we are, Bryan Nehman, when it comes to Major League Baseball and no games at a minimum until April the 14th. Of course, for us here with the Baltimore Orioles, that means April the 15th, the first Friday game against the Yankees, New York Yankees in S Series. But coming up the next hour after the 7:30 news, we're going to be joined by Dr. Mary Kate Schneider. She has been our global Loyola University person looking at what's happening with Russia, Ukraine. We've been talking with her just about every week now to find out what things are looking like on the ground and what to look for in the future. And after the 7 o'clock news, a 12-year-old, everyone, a 12-year-old arrested in Anne Arundel County with a carjacking. And wait till you hear the rest of that story. It's just, it's incredible. But yesterday, when people thought and were tweeting, Bryan, that there might be a deal on the table between Major League Baseball and the Major League Baseball Players Association, things broke down over all things international baseball.
Yeah, the international draft, which, you know, apparently owners have been asking for quite some time. I hadn't even heard that this was an issue.
A lot of people
had negotiations. And it sounded like, again, that they were getting close,
yeah,
that they've, you know, kind of narrowed the big gaps that they had on the economic things. And all of a sudden, this got thrown into the mix, and this was a poison pill.
It really was.
And so now they're all looking at each other and pointing fingers. And so now they're further apart than they were before, it sounds like. But,
and they're,
you know,
angry.
Who
Look,
knows?
Here's what the players' union released immediately once the owners said that the next week, one more week of games would be canceled until April the 14th. The owner's decision to cancel additional games is completely unnecessary. After making a set of comprehensive proposals to the league earlier this afternoon and being told substantive responses were forthcoming, players have yet to hear back. Players want to play, and we cannot wait to get back on the field. What that tells me, Bryan, is that somebody's not communicating something to somebody.
Yeah.
Somewhere, when they make statements like that.
And does one side really not care if there is baseball?
Right. Are we at a point now where we are 1981, you know, or something like that?
Look, from the very beginning, this was reported by all of the guys, the baseball writers who know this stuff very well, that this was going to be ugly and it was going to last very long. Mm-hmm. There were initial warnings from, you know, the Tim Kerpsons of the world that it was going to be probably July before they were going to play
that.
Baseball.
Okay.
Yeah, they said that. Jeff Passan said that as well, that it was going to be ugly. Now, this was in November.
Okay.
But then things sounded like, well, maybe it's not as bad as we thought. Perhaps we could even get the season in. And then they extended the day for 24 hours, and that didn't work out. And now this again, we're getting close. And then they throw in the international draft. I mean, the problem is when you get close to a deal,
right,
and then something
new
breaks
comes
it
on the
down,
table, right,
there's comes some type of new weapon that is basically put in there, or a poison pill, if you will, then that creates even more friction. It creates more animosity.
Well, you lose trust.
And you might wind up actually, you know, drawing this thing out even longer. So that is the concern now, is that, well, you know, maybe we would get it in April. Now, you know, maybe we don't
get
it
until
July. Well,
here's the thing, everybody, I think, that comes out of this. Rob Manfred is the problem now. Everybody's saying the commissioner of baseball. And even if they do come up with an agreement, people are suggesting he might be severely wounded coming out of this. There's no trust in him whatsoever.
Well, the players hate him.
Right.
Players have always hated him. But
have they always hated him? I didn't know if they always did.
Yeah, they've not liked him.
Okay.
Remember the whole thing with the trophy, you know, the Astros and him saying
it's just a piece of hardware. Yeah, that. I remember
that.
They
were on him because he was practicing his golf swing the other day.
Okay.
He was going to videotape that during the negotiations. You know, it's basically
saying he's dealing in bad faith.
It.
Well, I'm saying in this situation, they're basically saying he's dealing in bad
faith.
Well,
who does he work for?
Exactly, the owners.
Exactly. So, I mean, he's doing what the owners want him to do. That is his job. Now, to the international draft, I don't know why this came up now or what wasn't there. But I gotta say, I'm with the owners on this. It is, you know, an international draft as opposed to, you know, picking up kids when they're 16
right.
years old or 15 years old, putting them in some academy.
Like we did Manny Machado.
And paying them millions of dollars. No, Manny Machado's American, don't forget, even though he played for the Dominican for the World Series of Baseball.
But didn't we discover him in Dominican Republic?
No, he's an American who was drafted by the Orioles. He played for the team Dominican because his grandfather was from there. That's what got me
but
so
upset. He was 16.
But he was American.
Okay.
From Miami.
Okay.
But all these other
Glad
guys that are from the Dominican and from, you know, other countries that they have to say, all right, should I bet on this kid at the age of 16? And they sign him to these contracts. They make these academies, or you get somebody from one of the Asian countries and you pay him a ridiculous amount of money.
Right.
What they're saying is, you know, why go through that? Let's just have a draft. Mm-hmm. a 20 round draft where 600 players would be taken on a yearly basis.
But to me, Bryan,
what's wrong with that?
I'm going to tell you what's wrong with that. To bring that in, that's something to me that needs a lot of negotiation. You don't just have that in a couple of days. That's something that should be separated from what's going on right now and then negotiated. Bringing that in with this, it's not as easy to me as what you just said. I think that definitely needs to be, because you're talking about a lot of kids being left out of the draft potentially, American kids.
Well, it's separate from that.
But why would you pick a lot of kids here if you know you have an opportunity to get a lot of kids internationally?
It's not going to change what that. It's a numbers game. It's a number game. But I'll throw it back at you, which has always bothered me. Is that why is it that a Dominican kid who's 16 years old can get a $10 million contract?
I totally agree.
And an American 16 year old can't.
Don't get me started on 1 year of basketball and then in college level, and then you go to the pros. I'm with you. I'm with you 100%.